What is up, New Beginnings Church? Happy Friday to you. Thank God it's Friday. We're going to end this week right with a great devotion as we wrap up this little sermon recap on maximizing your potential. This whole thing began as we looked at Matthew 25 and the parable of the talents. We find three people who were all given a little bit of time, a little bit of talent, a little bit of opportunity, and they were rewarded when they went out and gave their best and did their best. And then one of them was rebuked and punished when he basically, out of fear and laziness, buried it all in the ground. And so what I want to make sure that you understand is you have unbelievable potential. Don't bury it in the ground. Go out and maximize your potential. Potential is what you could be, but have not yet become. I want you to become everything that God has called you to, everything that God has put in your heart. I want you to reach that full potential. And so we talked about all kinds of things this week, like the pursuit and the application of knowledge, the ability to kind of cover up your weaknesses, and make sure your weaknesses don't derail you, the principles and standards you live by, that certain standards will just lift you up even if you are a little begrudging about it even. And so anyway, some really, really good stuff. But I want to give you a powerful principle here, and it's one we do talk about regularly here at New Beginnings, and it's this. If you want to maximize your potential, one of the ways that you do that is through the relationships that you prioritize and value. Let me say that again. The relationships that you prioritize and value. If you will get the right people in your life, they will help you elevate. They will help you grow. They will help you think differently. They'll help give you some of those new standards and principles to live by. They're going to bring you some of that knowledge that you need to gain and then apply. It comes from people. And so anyway, if you don't believe me, Proverbs 13:20 is the most easy way to put it. He who walks with wise men will be wise, but the companion of fools will be destroyed. So this principle works really in both directions. If we hang around with a bunch of people who have bad habits, bad qualities, low character, they're going to bring chaos and drama and darkness into our life. And so Solomon in the Proverbs says, no, walk with wise people. Just by walking with wise people, it's as if wisdom has some type of osmosis to it, meaning if you just get around it, it'll eventually rub off on you. That there is some truth to that. If you get around, let me just again break it down into arenas. You say, you know what, I really want to grow as a parent. Here's what I do. I go find the best, smartest, wisest parents that I can find. And I would say, hey, you know what? Can I just buy you coffee? Can I take you to lunch? I'd love to ask you some questions. You seem like you have a lot of wisdom when it comes to parenting, and I want to pick your brain. Again, if you were going into any type of a field, some type of occupation, if you said, Todd, I want to go be an attorney, I would find the best, smartest, brightest attorney that I could, and I'd be like, hey, can I come intern for you? I'll work for free, whatever. I just want to get around you. I want to ask questions. I want to see what habits and disciplines and thoughts, and I just want to get around that. And so what we want to do is think about, if we're going to get to that place where we reach all of our fullest potential, it's going to come from some of the people that we prioritize. Because a lot of times what we do is we end up just defaulting down to our relationships, meaning we just hang out with whoever's around. We hang out with whoever's available. We hang out with whoever happens to be in proximity to us. Not successful people. They don't hang out with just whoever. They seek people that they want to invest time with because they know that time will bring a reward in their life. I'm going to invest some time with somebody a little bit older, smarter, more accomplished, more wisdom than me. I'm going to go ask them a bunch of great questions. I'm going to glean from all their wisdom, because if I'll prioritize relationships with people who are ahead of me and have already maybe reached that level of their potential, they're going to help me. They're going to elevate me to that next level. And so anyway, just remember this, wisdom is contagious. Successful people seek out wise counsel and allow their wisdom to guide their attitudes and decisions. Can I get an amen to that? Church, let me pray for you today. Father, I lift up everyone within the sound of my voice. God, I pray that, God, we would have some unbelievably godly and wise people around us. And God, may we go seek them out. May we ask them questions. May we seek out their knowledge and understanding, God, so that we can apply that to our lives, Lord. Father, help us, Lord, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Church, I love you guys. God bless you. I will see you this Sunday morning, 10 a.m., live or online. God bless you.